Transpiration is loss of water in the form of vapor. The plants absorb the capillary water. Out of the 100% of the water, only 1% of the water is being utilized for metabolic activities of plants, and remaining 90% of the water is lost through the transpiration. So, transpiration play a very important role in SPAC concept: soil, plant, atmosphere, continuum. There, the water is absorbed by the roots, and the absorbed water is transpired through the stomata and reached onto the atmosphere. And from atmosphere to soil, it reached by the rains. It means there is a continuous relationship among the soil, plant, as well as atmosphere, that is maintained between the, maintained through the evaporation as well as absorption. The transpiration is carried at stomata. The stomata is have the two cells. The two cells are kidney shaped cells. They are called as God cells. So, between the God cells, the stomata pore is there. Through that pore, the gaseous exchange is carried out. Beside the subsidiary cells, beside the God cells, there are subsidiary cells. Based on the orientation of subsidiary and God cells, the stomata are divided into many types. And according to their functioning, they are divided into two types: photoactic stomata and stactoactic stomata. Photoactic stomata is opened at opened during the light time and remain closed at dark time, night time. And stactoactive stomata are opened at night but remained closed in light. The best example of photostatic stomata are cactus and bryophyllum. And the transpiration affected by external factors like temperature, light, air, and wind speed. The internal factors are include number of stomata, distribution of stomata, opening and closing of stomata, and shoot root ratio. These all are affected the transpiration. How the mechanism of transpiration is carried out? The mechanism of transpiration is dependent onto the absorption of water. Absorption of water. When the God cells are absorb the water, they become turgid. So, the turgid cells are easy to become as crescent shaped, and the stomata pore is open. And also the opening of stomata is depends on to the orientation of microfibrils present in cellular microfibrils present in the cell wall of God cells. When they are radial, the cellular microfibrils are radial, then the stomata easy to open. And also the water, when the God cell is rich with water, then that become turgid. In the turgid shape, the stomata pore is opened. In the loss of water conditions, the stomata become flaccid. It means the God cells become flaccid and the stomata pore is remained closer. And closing and opening of, closer and opening of stomata explained by the scientist Leavitt. Leavitt, he explained the opening and closure of stomata by K plus ions pump theory. K plus ions pump theory. According to this theory, the K plus ions are transmitted from subsidiary cells to God cell. They are transported from subsidiary cells to God cells. So, they are accumulated in the God cells. The concentration of the K plus ions are increased. Along with that, K plus ions concentration, the influx of Cl minus ions also carried out into God cells. Additionally, the efflux of H plus ions also carried out towards the subsidiary cells. You see here, by the accumulation of C plus and Cl minus ions, the water potential is decreased in the God cells.